Konnichiwa, this is the Shogunstein, and we're going to do a review of a mind-messing little game called Cockroach Poker, or Kakalaka Poker, because it's German. And I'd like to thank the guys at Shut Up and Sit Down who recommended this game on their website, and then without their review, we would never even known this game exists. So Cockroach Poker, it works from 2 to about 6 players, 15-25 minutes. Not as good with 2 players. You definitely need 3, better with 4, better with 6. Higher play count, more fun. So very simple game to use. Now this is the regular edition. There is a deluxe version that eliminates the spider faction. So see, here's the spider. And then has like a, like almost like a wild card that the other reviews say is a little confusing to use. And you got to get the German version to do that. So if you get the American version, it's going to come with the spider faction. So you have 8 suits, and they're all insects. So here you got the frogs or the toads. You got the cockroaches. You got the flies. You got what I'm the year of the rat. You got the spiders. You got the bats. You got the stink bugs. And you got the scorpions. And this game is very simple to play. What happens is you're going to deal out all the cards. And the first person that goes is going to pick any player. Doesn't matter what order you go in. Now you can look at your cards. And again, on the top of the cards are all the suits. In the beginning, it is maybe a little confusing between the cockroach and the stink bug. So that's maybe the hardest thing to learn in the beginning, is just the difference between the two. So what's going to happen is you're going to look at your card. And again, you can look at your hand. So you can, you know, you can look at any of the cards. And let's say I take the rat, because that's what I am. Like a nice, big, fat New York City rat, subway rat.
Ew.
That's right. And I'm going to say, let's say I went to Little Shogunstein. Now, this is a rat. Now, let's say I was honest. I said, I got a rat. And I would pass him, Little Shogunstein, the card. And Little Shogunstein has,
I believe him.
2 options. He can either call me out on the card, where he's going to say it's a rat, or he's going to say I'm lying, it's not a rat. Or he can pick up the card, look at it, and then pass it to someone else. So let's say he calls me out, and he says, I believe you, it's a rat. We look at the card, and it was a rat.
Dun, dun, dun.
So I lost because he correctly identified it, and I'm stuck with the rat. In this game, there's no winner. There's just one loser. It's like the Diamondbacks, other than 2001, losers, right? So, well, we know Gonzo cheap hit off Mariano. Got to see that highlight every time. So, to lose, if you get 4 of the same suits, you're out. Again, there's no winner, just a loser. Now, if I had said it was a rat and Little Shogunstein had said, you're lying, it's a toad, when I showed him the card, and since it was a rat and he was wrong, he'd get stuck with the card, and then it's his turn. However, in a game with more than 2 people, which again, we recommend more than 2 people, he could not call me out at all, and he can say, he's just going to take the card.
I can say I played chess today.
And then he can look at it, and then he'll see what card it was, and he can decide either to perpetuate my lie or my truth. So he can look at it, and then he can go to the next person. Yeah, it's a rat. And then the process starts over again. Or he can look at it, and he can say, no, it's a bat. And he passes the card over.
Oh, no, it's a rat. It's a bat.
The process starts over until the last. So whether it's 3 players, 6 players, the last person left then has to make the call on whether or not the person is
lying. They cannot pick it up.
They cannot pick it up. They have to say, you know, I believe you or not believe you. So it's a very simple game, and takes, you know, maybe 2 or 3 minutes to learn. But once you start playing, it really is something that messes with your mind, because is the person lying? Is the person telling the truth? It becomes pretty cutthroat. So very easy game to pack up and carry with you. I bring it to work, and we got an extra few minutes.
There's also one rule he forgot. When you lose, you always go next. No tones.
Right. So when you, if you're stuck with the card, then you lead. And you play until one person loses. So we like this game a lot. It's even got Mrs. Shogunstein playing, and she doesn't like to play any games with us. Little Shogunstein, do you have any comments on the game?
I beat him always. I always beat him.
Well, you don't win. Daddy tends to
lose.
So again, in this game, there are no winners, just a loser. Game's about $10 on Amazon. Totally worth it. Little Shogunstein, how many dabs do you give Cockroach poster? Poker, not poster. Go. Well, how many dabs?
What?
I said Cockroach
poster. I don't like a poster of a cockroach.
That was how many dabs?
4.5.
4.5 out of 5 dabs for Cockroach poster. Again, thank you to the guys from Shut Up, Sit Down for recommending this game. And I've played it with people that hate games, such as Mrs. Shogunstein, and I brought it to the Arizona Game Fair and played it with a bunch of gamers, and they loved it. And, oh, we did hit one warning. We did play with someone with arachnophobia, and they were really freaked out by the spider card. So it sounds silly, but people that really do have a fear of bugs might not handle this game.
And there's one more thing.
Very well.
One more thing.
What's that?
If you're playing 2 players, you need 5 to get the other person out.
Yes, thank you for reminding us that 2-player game, it needs 5. But again, we really recommend it with minimum 3, but it's better with 4 or 5 so you can pass the card around. So Shogunstein, Little Shogunstein, out.